that integration of New Orleans school system, even though her father was hesitant. In early 1960, Bridges was one of the six black kids. And this all-white school was named William France Elementary. Two of the six decided to stay at their old school. Bridges went to the school by herself, and three children were transferred to McDonough and became known as the McDonough Three. Bridges and her mother was escorted to the school by four federal marshals during the first year she attended the school. When she was walking, people were shouting and throwing things. Later, United States Deputy Marshal Charles Burke said she showed a lot of courage. She didn't cry, she didn't whimper, she just marched like a little soldier. And her family said, we're very, very proud of her. As soon as Bridget entered school, parents were pulling their kids out. Teachers refused to teach while a black child was present. Only one person agreed to teach, and that was Barbara Henry. And Ruby was the only one in class. But now, Ruby is 62 and still lives in New Orleans with her husband and four children. And believe it or not, her teacher is still alive and is 85. This picture is when she was by herself and Miss Barbara Henry was teaching her. This picture at the bottom is when they came knocking on her door, and this picture is when she was being escorted to the school. Questions?
Yes. What were some of the things that people said to her while she was walking up to the school?
Some people said 2, 4, 6, 8, we don't want to integrate. And then one lady screamed out, I'll poison her.
Wow. What does the word integration mean?
To mix colored people and white people together.
That's cool. And what was the greatest lesson that you learned from doing this research?
That Ruby Bridges was brave.
Brave.
For walking through a crowd of large people who didn't want her to be somewhere with their children.
Right. And so if you were to, one word that you would say describes Ruby Bridges, one word.
Brave.
Brave. Thank you, Maya.